Ready to unlock the power of your documents with an Appian? Documents such as invoices, reports, claims, and images are part of almost any application. When you use record types to manage your documents, you can easily incorporate them into your larger data fabric. In this video, you'll learn the benefits of managing documents with record types, including faster development and simplified document management setup, AI-powered smart search and document chat, simplified document security, and direct querying of document properties and content. This approach is powerful for documents related to your business data. However, it's important to know when this doesn't apply. Keep in mind, for documents that support your design objects, such as logos or icons, you should continue to use document folders for organization. Now let's get started. Imagine Acme Auto, a fleet management operation grappling with vast vehicle documentation, specs, registration, customer photos, and insurance claims. For Acme Auto, they can easily manage, relate, and secure these documents using a record type. Using relationships, Acme Auto can relate all relevant documents to an individual vehicle. Configuring record-level security allows for more granular access control, so documents are only visible to users who can see the vehicle information. And best of all, AI features like Smart Search and Document Chat can leverage the documents and their properties so application users can seamlessly find the information they need. When thinking about documents, you should consider them as any other business data that you manage with record types. Your data model will look like this. You already have record types that store core business data, like vehicles or customers. Then, that will relate to a document management record type, which points to the document file. This record type is automatically related to the out-of-the-box document record type, which contains the properties for all the document files in the environment. The document management record type is the central piece you'll create for managing your documents. Its primary purpose is to control how documents relate to your business data, as well as their security and storage. This record type needs to have a document ID field of type document. This document ID field stores the ID of the actual document file and relates to the out-of-the-box document record type. Additionally, when you add a field of type document, a dedicated folder is generated where your documents associated with this record type are stored. You can create multiple document management record types in your application. This is particularly useful when different types of documents have unique security requirements or need to store different associated data. For instance, Acme Auto might create a customer document record type to manage agreements associated with each customer, and a separate vehicle document record type for vehicle-related documents. The second record type you'll use is the out-of-the-box document record type, which exists in every Appian environment. You don't need to create or configure it. It holds the properties for all documents, such as the file's name, extension, and size. Finally, remember to connect your core business data to the document data. From your business data record type, add a one-to-many relationship to the document management record type. For Acme Auto, this means that from a single vehicle record, you can now query and display a complete list of all its related documents all in one unified view. Let's quickly review. To manage documents with record types, you'll use two record types: a document management record type that relates to your business data, and the out-of-the-box document record type. The document management record type controls the relationships, security, and storage of your documents. The system document record type provides key information about the files, like their name and extension, which you can then query and display. Continuing with our Acme Auto example, let's see how we'd use record types to manage vehicle documents. I already have a vehicle record type, which contains my core vehicle information, like make, model, VIN, and year. I need to create a document management record type to manage the various types of documents associated with each vehicle. To do this, I'll generate it directly from the vehicle record type. In the vehicle record type, I'll click Modify Source Fields, then, in the Documents banner, select Generate Record Type. This vehicle document record type will store document identifiers and relate them to individual vehicles. I can also add a list of document types. I'll add Acme Auto's vehicle documents like specifications, registration, customer photos, and insurance claims. Later, I can use this information to search, filter, and organize the documents, making it easy to find what I need. This lookup data, like other choice lists, will be stored in a related record type. I'll click Generate, Save, and close this dialog. Now, I'll open the vehicle document record type. Notice that it has the crucial document field, which establishes its relationship to the document record type. Also, there's a many-to-one relationship from the vehicle document record type back to the vehicle record type, so that multiple documents can be associated with a single vehicle. Now, let's look at one of the most powerful advantages of record types, unified security. Document security is automatically inherited from the record-level security of the vehicle document record type itself. With record-level security, you can configure security rules that only allow users to see the vehicle documents if they can also see the vehicle information. Now, let's upload a document when creating a new vehicle record. First, I'll head to my vehicle record type and generate a Create Vehicle action. Next, I'll open the generated form to demonstrate the user experience. Notice this great wizard layout to add vehicle data. In the first step, I'll enter the vehicle details. Next, I'll proceed to an editable grid where a user would upload documents for this specific vehicle. Keep in mind, the actual data is saved when a user submits this form within a process, but this shows how easily you can configure the upload experience. When I upload this document, I don't need to create a folder. The system automatically handles document storage in a generated, hidden folder within the system. This abstraction means you no longer need to create or manage folders on your own. I'll go ahead and add the types of documents these are. Once the user submits the form and the data is saved in the process, the uploaded document becomes associated with this specific vehicle. To manage or troubleshoot any issue with vehicle documents, I can go to the Documents page of the Vehicle Document Record Type. This page serves as the centralized location for viewing and interacting with all documents associated with this specific record type. Here, I can see all the vehicle documents displayed clearly, along with their properties such as file name and extension. If a document is no longer relevant, I can delete it directly from this page. This action deletes both the record and the actual document file from Appian. Now that we've seen how to manage documents, let's explore how to access their properties directly within a record list or grid. I can display document properties as columns to see key details at a glance. For example, in my vehicle record list, a configured column displays the extension, such as PDF or JPEG, of the primary document associated with each vehicle. You can do this by querying the related vehicle document record type and selecting the extension field from its associated document record, enabling dynamic reporting and precise data analysis based on document content. You'll also unlock powerful AI features like Smart Search. This enables you to search not just based on document properties, but deeply into the actual content of your documents. Let's see how to configure it. First, I'll go into the vehicle document record type. On the left, I find the Smart Search page. Here, I simply select the document field to make it searchable and save the record type. With that configured, I can now search my documents. I'm going to switch over to a similar example to show you this in action. In this claim site, there are documents associated with claim records. As a manager, I might want to find specific information within those documents. For example, let's say I want to know how many of these claims are for people interested in renewing. I can go up here and search for renewal. Notice the results. None of these claim titles or other details have the word renewal in them, but the documents do. You can see the first one returned is an actual renewal policy document. The search also found this other document, just called Update. When I open it, you'll see it's actually a policy change request. This is the power of semantic search. It finds records based on the meaning of your data. A change request is similar to a renewal, so the search was able to find it and deliver these relevant results. To learn more about Smart Search, see the resources listed in this video's description. In this video, you learned how record types transform document management by integrating documents into your data fabric. This offers a simplified setup, unified security, and advanced query and search capabilities. Thanks for watching. To learn more about Appian, be sure to check out the resources in the description. And to stay on top of Appian topics, remember to like this video, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to see more videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video.